John. Welcome to Mr. G's Workbench. And it's been a while since we built something. The last thing we did was the ICM OV10A Bronco. And I was pretty happy with that. I've kind of run under the radar for a while. We did a couple of show reports. We, you know, we talked about crappy kits and stuff. So today, we're not building a crappy kit. We're going to get a start on an actually really good kit. And it's one we did, one of my rare open box experiences. We did the special hobby boxing of the ICM AH-1G Cobra. This is their Early Tales over Nam. And this is their high-tech boxing. And their high-tech boxing usually involves extra parts. We talked about that. You get photo etch, you get resin, you get some 3D printed parts. My first real experience with 3D printed parts. So we'll see how they go. There's a lot of them in the cockpit. So we're gonna jump in and let's get the cockpit built today, all right? And see how it comes out, all right? Let's take a look at the parts. Just wanted to take a quick second out of this video to tell you about three different ways you can support Mr. G's Workbench and the work we do here. The first way you're doing right now, you're watching the video. If you like this video, don't forget to like it, and you can leave a comment as well. The next way you can support Mr. G's Workbench is by becoming a subscriber. Hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon, and be notified every time I put out a new video. And you'll be my friend forever if you do. The final way you can support Mr. G's Workbench, if you really like what we're doing here, I hope you'll consider becoming a channel member. If you go to the homepage on YouTube for Mr. G's Workbench and hit the blue join button, it's $1.99 US per month, and everything that comes in through channel memberships goes towards equipment and hopefully making better videos. So I hope you'll consider channel membership as well. Thank you to everyone who's already signed up. It's very much appreciated. Now back to our video. We'll be right back. Well, there you have it. Cockpit is done. I'm pretty happy with it. I'm pretty happy with the result. I just need to throw a layer of dull coat on it and tone everything down. We got that, which isn't going to focus because it's too busy looking at my face, I think. There you go. We'll take a quick rundown of what's in it. I'll show you some close-ups and I'll just run through really quick. You got the ICM cockpit from the original kit, and then Special Hobby throws in a bunch of stuff to bump the cockpit up to the next level, which, thank you very much, Special Hobby. They give you some photo etched seat belts, which they're that typical, obviously Edouard manufactured them. They're the typical pre-finished metal seat belts that Edouard gives you. They went on well. They were easy to assemble, no issues. And I'm pretty happy with them. After I installed them, I threw a layer of brown oil paint wash on them to tone them down a little. So I did that. They also give you, Special Hobby gives you some resin seat cushions and resin seats for the cockpit. Beautifully molded, like most of their stuff these days. I was very happy with them. Painted them up, put them in. Again, when I put that brown oil paint wash over the seat belts, I put it on the cushions as well. And it helped to kind of differentiate some of the patterns on the seats. So I was happy with that. Instrument panels, Edouard's, I think they call them Lepto, something like that. It's the later instrument panels they make, not the 3D printed ones. These are photo etch, but where the gauges themselves, have a clear coating over them to replicate the glass. So they give you that front and back on that. Really nice. The only thing you use for the instrument panels from the original kit is the cowlings. So we did that. They give you some resin. I don't know what they are. There's the front seat, the gunner. On either side of the gunner seat, there are some pouches. They give them to you in resin. They look better than what was apparently supposed to be there. The collective for the pilot is resin as well. Then they give you some 3D printed stuff. It was great to work with the 3D printed parts. They cut away from the part that they come printed on really easily. Easy to clean up. I was really happy with them. They give you the control stick for the pilot. It is 3D printed. A beautiful heads-up display in 3D. It separated really well, like I said, cleaned up really well. I was very happy with the final product. And then I don't know what it is in the gunner seat. Instead of a control stick, there's some kind of two-handled gizmo. I'm sorry, I don't know what it's called. But that's also 3D printed. All that stuff went in really well. They also give you a joystick for the gunner that's on the right side of the seat. That's 3D printed as well. All really well done. So I'm really happy with the way the cockpit has come out, and I'm looking forward to the engine is going to be assembled next. You could just, you know, slap it all together, close up the doors, and pretend it's not there. I think I'm going to do it with a panel open and show the engine. I've got some nice pictures that I found on the interwebs of a Cobra's engine and transmission. I think what you're seeing isn't really the engine. What they leave the panels open for is the transmission and stuff. I think I'm going to build it with one of the doors open because it doesn't look bad and I've got good references. So I think we're going to jump on that. And I like the kit so far. It's a winner. It's great to work on something that's actually inspiring. So, oh, and there's one more thing that's going to go in the cockpit that's 3D printed. It was a fire extinguisher. After I had assembled the cockpit and got everything done for the video, I realized that I had this fire extinguisher. So I'm going to paint it up and I'll install it in the next episode. So I think the next episode is probably going to be doing that transmission, getting the fuselage assembled, and creeping ever closer to paint. So I'm looking forward to that. Thanks for stopping in. We're up over 1530 subscribers. Like I said earlier in the video, thank you very much for tuning in. Thank you even more for subscribing. Don't forget about channel memberships if you're so inclined. And I will see you guys next time. Take care. Stay well.